Hi, Dr. Jay here, and I want our topic of for today's video to be about flexibility and mobility, and those are very important to give yourself very healthy joints and undo the stress of most of our work days or work lives. See, most people throughout the course of the day are in this position where you're sitting down, hunched forward, and looking down at a keyboard, or you know, many times nowadays we're looking down at technology, whether it be our phones or iPads or our tablets or whatnot. And what happens over many years is you literally start to create rigidity in your body, tension or tightness in your muscles that force you, whether you realize it or not, force you into this position here. And so what that ends up doing is it's wearing down prematurely on your joints and your shoulders, your hips, your knees, your ankles, your neck, and literally speeding up the aging process. And when our patients come in, they ask me, hey doc, I want to do some flexibility, I want to work on my hamstrings, I feel like they're tight, you know, I'm going to stretch my back. I'm here to tell you, it's no discredit to those people, but truthfully speaking, if you're looking to get the most efficiency and the most effectiveness with your stretching routine, you want to really focus on stretching the muscles of the front of your body, with one exception, and I'm going to get to that in just a moment. So what I've put together is a 5 minutes to flexibility routine for all of you out there. Again, should be very easy to accommodate any lifestyle, any schedule, and you're going to see there's some modifications that we can do throughout all of these stretches to meet you wherever you are, just to make sure you're moving your body, you're stretching your body to age appropriately. The first muscle we're going to work on is your calf muscle. This is the one that goes outside of what I just said. Now we're going to stretch the front of our body mainly, but the calf muscle is very important, again, because its connection to the hip, the hamstrings, the lower back, and the fact that we're sitting for a long period of time, getting chronically tight ankles, feet, and calf. So the way we're going to stretch our calves is you're going to find a step in your home or in your office setting, and you're going to place your foot on the step. And you're going to just get a nice stretch of that calf muscle here in the back. If you need some support, you can hold on to a wall or a railing. As you get more flexibility, you're going to lean into that stretch. And again, you're going to feel even more of a stretch into the calf and even part of the lower part of your hamstring here. You want to hold this stretch, and any stretch for that matter, for about 30 seconds to really give your muscle a chance to open up and unwind. So I'll hold this stretch for 30 seconds. And then I'm going to repeat on the other leg as well. The next stretch we're going to be working on is actually working in the front of our legs, our called quads. Again, these quads on the front of your hips are chronically tight because of all the years and thousands, hundreds of thousands of hours of sitting. So one of those stretches that we're going to be doing is something called a couch stretch. And I call it a couch stretch because you can use a couch or a chair to assist you in this stretch. So what you're going to do is you're going to place your foot on the seat part of a couch or a chair, and what you're going to do is you're going to lower yourself down. Now, in doing this, you're going to feel a stretch into the front of your leg and into your hip and even into the lower abdominal area. You want to keep your body very upright, looking straight ahead. Now, in order to increase the intensity of the stretch, you can bring your knee closer to the chair or closer to the couch, and again, you're going to feel a much more intense stretch. Now, if you can't get to this position, you again can at least put your foot up on the back of a couch or chair, have another chair in front of you, and just start by lowering here. And over time, you'll get the flexibility where you eventually go all the way down. Again, you want to hold this leg stretch here for minimally 30 seconds, and then you're going to repeat the opposite side as well. And then after we do the quads, we're going to work on stretching the chest, the biceps, and the neck. And the way we do that is you're going to find a wall or a corner of a wall, and you're going to place your hand, your forearm, and your elbow on that corner of the wall, just like so. And then with your body, you're going to turn your body away from your armpit, away from your elbow, turning it here. Now, as I'm in this position, I've got some tension here, and now I'm just going to simply lean in a little bit, and I can clearly feel a stretch into my chest and even my bicep. Now what we're going to do is we're going to look away, and now I'm stretching the muscles in front of my neck, into the chest, into the bicep. I'm going to hold this stretch for, again, 30 seconds, and then I'm going to repeat it with the opposite side. Now, up to this point, we've stretched the calf, the quad, the chest, and we're now going to actually work on the muscles of your abdominal area, stretching them, and at the same time, starting to create mobility or better movement into the lower back. This move here is called a lower back extension. And how it's performed is you'll lay on the ground, and then what you'll do is you'll just get fully relaxed, and you're going to push your chest off of the ground while trying to maintain your hips on the ground. You also want to try your best to get your butt to relax. Not to be tight, get tight, but you want to relax. You're going to come back down, and then go back up. This is a movement, this is not a stretch. You want to get lots of repetitions in. So ideally speaking, you'd like to get 30 repetitions of this movement every time you do it. Now, initially, you may not be able to come all the way up, and that's okay, but over time, you'll start getting more flexibility into your abdominal and hip area, and you'll start improving the movement of your lower back. And the last move we're going to do, we're going to use something called a foam roller. And just as the name implies, it's a roll, and it's a hard, dense foam. And we're going to use this to literally improve movement in our entire spine. We're going to use this tool as well to break up scar tissue that's developed around your joints, your muscles, from decades worth of falls, injuries, or again, sitting at a desk. The way we use the foam roller is you literally will put it on the ground, you're going to lay on it, like so, starting at the mid to low back, give yourself a hug, keeping your butt on the ground initially, and you're going to use your legs to pull you down and push you up. As you do this, you may hear some popping-like sounds in your mid-back. That's fine. That's just the joints moving. You're going up and down. Now, as you get stronger, you may be able to lift your legs and your butt off the ground and go up and down as well. Initially, when you do this activity, it might not be very comfortable because, again, this tool is being used to help break up scar tissue and get joints to move that haven't moved in a very long time. But stay with it, and over time, you'll feel great every time you get on it. So again, in recap, 5 minutes of flexibility. You're going to go through a 30-second for each side routine of first the calf stretch, and then you're going to be doing the quad stretch for 30 seconds on the calf stretch here. And then we'll be moving to the bicep, chest, and neck stretch here. After we do that for 30 seconds for each side, you're then going to be going on the ground and doing the extension move that we alluded to for 30 repetitions. And then lastly, ending with a foam roll session for about 30 seconds as well. Again, when you do these things with repetition each and every day, you will improve your flexibility, which in turn will allow you to age correctly and not speed up the arthritic or the aging process. So hopefully this helps some of you. Hopefully it blesses some of you. Any questions or concerns, feel free to reach out to me. I look forward to helping all of you. And again, look forward to seeing you all next week. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Bye now.